reapply. Think of the aging. Welcome back to the Adore Beauty YouTube channel. My name is Amy Clark. I'm the senior editor at Adore Beauty. And today's video, I promise it's going to be short and snappy and very informative. But please watch to the end because we are talking about a really important topic today, which is how to reapply your sunscreen. In this video, I'm going to cover A, why do you have to reapply sunscreen? And B, how to apply it over the top of a face of makeup. And I'm also going to dispel some common sunscreen makeup myths. So keep watching. Let's go back to basics for a moment. If you spend money on skincare or serums or anything, skincare treatments, you're literally pouring money down the drain if you are not applying sunscreen. Sunscreen is the number one anti-aging product out there. This is because UV damage, you know, from overexposure to the sun is a major factor that causes aging. And I'm talking things like the skin appearance, skin tone, fine lines and wrinkles, pigmentation, you name it, sun exposure can cause it. In any good skincare routine, sunscreen will be the last step before you start applying makeup. Ideally, SPF 50 plus, but you know, SPF 30 is better than nothing for sure. Then you can go over the top with whatever makeup products you wear. So if you wear foundation or a primer or anything like that, that all layers on once you've let your sunscreen sink in. Sometimes it takes a few minutes or so. Now onto why you need to reapply. Often we've all heard about how we need to reapply sunscreen after we go swimming, after sweating, all that kind of jazz. Same goes for your face sunscreen, just on a regular day. If you're working from an office or working from home, you might be sitting in front of a window like I am now. Some UV rays actually can penetrate through glass, which is why it's important that you reapply your face sunscreen in the same way that you would reapply your body sunscreen or sunscreen when you're at the beach after that 2-hour time period. People always say, okay, so I put my sunscreen on at the start of the day. And if you're not doing that, come on. And then I've put this beautiful face of makeup on. I've spent so much time. I'm looking great. So how do I then apply sunscreen over the top of my makeup without having to redo my makeup or without it ruining my makeup? Well, I am here to help. Look, I'm not gonna bullshit you. Applying sunscreen over the top of a full face of makeup is kind of annoying and it's a little bit tricky, but there are ways to do it. I'm just gonna put my hair up. I've just done a really gorgeous little top knot there for you. What kind of sunscreen is the best sunscreen to reapply over the top of makeup? Excellent question. And in my opinion, chemical sunscreens that have a light fluid-like texture and a really thin consistency are the easiest to reapply over makeup because they sink into the skin really quickly. And because they're so light, you've got the best chance of not disturbing your base underneath. Some mineral or physical sunscreens can be quite thick. Those ones are hard to reapply over makeup because you really have to work them into the skin. Quick sidebar, the difference between UVA rays and UVB rays. Think of the A as aging, as often UVA rays cause the aging effects of sun damage. Think of B as standing for burn. They're the ones that physically burn the skin and give you that red, sore appearance. The next thing we need to talk about is how much to actually apply when you are reapplying your sunscreen throughout the day. So I've got a very scientific measuring device here. It's called a bloody teaspoon. To get SPF 50 plus protection with this sunscreen, I need to apply a teaspoon of sunscreen for my face, neck, and ears. I'm not necessarily saying that you have to measure out your sunscreen every time you go to use it, but it can be really handy when you're using a new sunscreen to just whip out the teaspoon, give it a measure, and then pop it in the palm of your hand. And then that way you can visually see what the right amount of sunscreen looks like and then just replicate that afterwards. But more is more when it comes to sunscreen. Have a look at the consistency of this one. When it comes out, I'm so graceful. I guarantee I'm gonna spill this everywhere. I'm gonna pop that into my hand. Oh my God, this is like, it's like I'm eating yogurt or something. That is how much sunscreen you need. I'm gonna go in and start dotting it around the face. She's dribbling. Okay, so this is about half of the sunscreen. Then you need a humble beauty blender. Any beauty blender will work really well. I've seen on TikTok and Instagram about using velvet or silicone ones or whatever. I am happy to just use a densely packed sponge like this because it won't soak up so much product. You are gonna start pouncing this little beauty blender around to slowly and gently blend in the makeup. So let's get started. You really want to be as gentle as possible, but this is your best chance of blending in the product without disturbing your makeup. Slow and steady wins the race. So that's our first layer. And then, you guessed it, I'm gonna go back over the top with the remaining sunscreen. And if you were wearing a dress like I am today, which has a beautiful V-neck, you would then also reapply on your neck, but I would not bother doing that with a beauty blender. Just do it as you normally would. Scandalous. Okay, round two, blending in with my beauty blender. Over the ears. What I'm gonna do is pop a before and after photo of my face wearing makeup just before this, and then my face about a minute or two after I finished applying, once it's kind of all sunk in and done its job. It is gonna move things around. Like when I look at my beauty blender, there is a little bit of makeup on there. And then I'll just go in and just touch up the tiniest bits. Always wash your hands after doing things with sunscreen. Actually, one other tip that I wanna give you is that if you are reapplying throughout the day, make sure your face is dry before you go in with your beauty blender and start reapplying. So if you're a bit sweaty, like we all get, or if you have an oily T-zone, just grab a tissue or blotting papers or even paper towel and just gently pat to soak up any moisture, because if there's moisture there, it can kind of all mix together and get a bit gluggy and it's not really the finish you're after. So dry everything down, then go in with your sunscreen. You can also pop some translucent powder over the top to set your T-zone, a shiny forehead, down the nose or on the chin if you are prone to shine. But I like to just embrace the dewiness. Finally, I want to bust a few quick myths about sunscreen reapplication. The first thing I want to address is a question I'll often get is, my foundation has SPF 10 or SPF 15, SPF 25. Even foundations like the IT Cosmetics CC cream that are SPF 50, can I just reapply by putting on more of my SPF foundation over the top? And the answer is no. And that is because you need a teaspoon of sunscreen to get SPF 50 coverage. Imagine how hectic your face would look with a teaspoon of IT Cosmetics CC cream or any foundation that has SPF in it, pumped into this and then put on your face. And if I'm talking about a foundation that has, say, SPF 25, then you would need to double that amount to get SPF 50 plus protection. So just don't even bother reapplying with a foundation that has SPF in it. The other thing I want to talk about is sunscreen sprays and powders. You're going to find that they're not actually mostly available in Australia, and that is because Australia has really strict, tough laws when it comes to sunscreens and what's actually safe to go on the shelves. It's actually a good thing for us because it means that our sunscreens are some of the most effective in the world. I think it's better safe and sorry, stick with a product that has been certified for safe use here in Australia. The last thing I want to touch on before I let you go, because I did say this video was going to be short and snappy. So say you are working from home, you're maybe just popping out for a walk to the post office later. Do I still have to reapply my sunscreen? Look, I am always for the side of caution, which is reapplying. I apply my sunscreen in the morning. If I know that I'm going to be heading out for a coffee or going for a short walk, I reapply. I will add that I don't really wear makeup on the days that I'm working from home, so it makes it super easy to reapply. I don't have to faff around with this bloody sponge business. But if you think about how expensive some skincare products are, take SkinCeuticals CE Ferulic, $218. There is no way in hell. I am gonna use that serum if I'm not applying my $30 sunscreen over the top. Jokes aside, sun safety is so important. It's really important to look after our skin in the Australian sun. And let's all have the healthiest, loveliest skin we can. If you have any questions at all, please pop your questions down here in the comments. But otherwise, go stay a while, take a look around at all the other very informative videos on the Adore Beauty YouTube channel. Hit subscribe and press the bell if you want to be notified about any future videos. And other than that, I'll see you next time.